Yeah. I sort of look at this sort of stage in your career and go, a couple of million albums under the belt, not so bad. A few awards knocking about as well.
Not bad. Yeah.
Fourth album you're on then now, obviously The Reason came out just at the end of last year.
Yeah.
Bit of a gap though between bringing it out.
Yeah.
And you said he needed a wee bit of a rest there.
Yeah.
2 years, isn't it, in between?
Yeah. It was almost 2 years. Yeah. Since my last tour to this one. I did need a little bit of a break. I think, you know, in order to stay fresh, in order to keep pushing the boat out, sometimes you need a little bit more thought. And also, sometimes you just need to stop to appreciate what's around you, because I was going really hard for about 5 or 6 years.
Yeah.
Just really, you know, album after album, tour after tour, country after country. I got to a stage where I felt like I'd proved one or two points. You know, I proved I can sing. I proved, you know, I can do one or two good albums. You know, third album in, and I thought, you know, the fourth album I wanted to give it a little bit more thought and just, you know, really push myself, and that's what I did. When you love me, oh, I got no road to follow. The best songs that connect with people are the ones that are the most honest ones.
Yeah.
You know, so I always try and just write songs about what I've been through or what I've seen around me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And with obviously the new single then coming out, Weight of the World, is that what you're feeling at the moment? You're feeling like...
Weight of the World. Yeah, do you know what? I don't know, what was I thinking about with that one? I was thinking about the social climate just in general. Like you know, with war and the whole, that whole malarkey. But also, just about, you know, when you lose someone as well. You know, I was just thinking that feels like the weight of the world as well. So, you know, I was just making comparisons. On this album, I've done that quite a bit, where songs have double meanings. So, you know, they've got a kind of a social kind of meaning and also a kind of a relationship type meaning as well.
You're entering a bit of a dark phase at the moment, dude. Is it? It's like secretly you're giving it all soul and praise, but secretly inside you're going, I'm feeling okay about stuff here.
Exactly, I'm feeling, you know, I need to talk about a few things here, you know?
Well, dude, thank you very much, Chance.
Thank
much
you,
appreciated.
Man. Thank you very much.
I have got one last. I did promise you quite a slightly dark question.
A dark question.
I apologise for it. I hope you're ready for this. It's a little bit. I've been crying today.
Okay.
Hopefully, after a happy and successful, fruitful life, you eventually pop your clogs.
Okay.
What would you like written on your gravestone?
What would I like written on my gravestone? Okay.
Anything you'd like there? Be people coming by. What kind of, I mean, like, Spike Milligan famously had "I Told You I Was Ill" written on his, which I think is literally quite genius. Says it all, really, doesn't
what
it?
Would I don't know.
Maybe a gold album or something pressed in there, something like that.
Do you know what? I'd like to say, he lived, he gave, he conquered.
Wow.
There we go.
Fair enough, then.
There we go.
I think I'd just have "Get Off My Grave" or something like that. Thank you very much, dude. Much appreciated.
Cool, man.
Cheers, pal.